see, but all Martin can think about is lunch.
Yeah, that one.
I'm compulsive
Hold on, I gotta call Whitey, okay?
Compulsive about anything that has to do with doors or the page and details and words and pointers and proposals and anything that has to do with tiles and things and words and
all that. Oh, thank you.
Hello?
Oh, thanks for holding, okay.
Then listen.
Yeah. Okay, yes. Yeah. Well, and also my pants and board concert.
75%
really?
Of the stuff is secretarial stuff, and yes. I'm not advertising my skills that I want someone to hire me.
Hold on.
I'm good at this stuff, and I love doing it. I mean, it's real fun. I can do it before. It's relaxing for me, you know, and I have a bulk mailing to do. I can play with that, and I actually enjoy doing the bulk mail.
I'm sorry, I'm
lettering them and knowing that they're all in order, and the little stickers that you use, the red D's and the green S's and the R's. I don't throw those rubber bands out. I save them for the bulk mailer. So I don't have to buy any rubber bands.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
There's this one bundle in every bulk mailing. I just love the bundle. I mean, I like it the best. The best thing about the mailing because
Riz, I know
only,
your work is good. Okay.
There's only one
I'll
bundle
come see
like
it next time.
And it's called
Honest,
Mixed
right.
States.
There's
only one Mixed States. I love that bundle.
Only one problem. Yeah, I know.
Most of the people that are your friends.
Most of the community. I'm not the only one involved.
Are you going over to do that session you just did?
exercise for you. The thing is, I've been doing this alone in the room for so long with no one watching. It would be really helpful for me to do it just with someone watching. You don't even have to say anything about it, but I thought you would be a good person.
Sure,
I'd like to maybe just watch it.
Okay. Well,
and if you feel like you need feedback, that would be great, but don't feel any pressure.
Sure. Okay.
This is part of a longer thing. I don't really know the context. But.
Okay, where's from?
Moments, Stephanie. It does. There's some nice moments in there.
Thanks.
Yeah. I would shorten it just a little, because I think the idea gets across.
I already cut it down to about a quarter just now, but I should.
No, the idea gets across,
no,
though.
It's real timing. It's real time development. And it's a process, a real time process. You and the audience are in on the same process together. Oh. You know, the tremors take a while to develop, and otherwise it's an artificial thing, and it's not about anything.
Oh, okay. I see.
Good.
Well, then I think it'll be just great.
Thanks.
Yeah, sure.
In another section, Skura has a kind of fit, and Margaret tries to calm her down. In their dialogue, we're getting a look at personal-professional relationships and see how politics is part of daily life in the fragile performance world.
And this is the before funding version.
Yeah. Well, I said it once in a while. Yeah, did you enjoy that concert a lot? Wasn't that fun? Yeah, well, I had a great time. Yes. Yeah. Well, I saw you across the lobby and I couldn't get over there. I was talking to a guy from BLA. Is that right? Yeah. Well, you know. Yeah. Well, so what'd you think? You tell me first. Yeah. Well, you know what? I thought that she got with the downtown stuff uptown. I mean, I know it was an uptown concert, and you know, uptown she had the slides and the video and the set and the costumes and all. And she didn't have that downtown, but I thought she kept what she had downtown uptown. Really, I did. Yes. It was uptown. Yes. But I think she got it. I didn't think she sold out. No, I know that's what they were saying at the cocktail party. I know it. Yeah. I know. But I think they're just jealous. Yeah. No, I think they're just jealous. She's doing so much work. You know, she got a commission there. Yeah, they're bringing her back next week. Next year, excuse me. Yes. Yeah, they're bringing her next year. And she's going to the Midtown Space Tour, doing 2 weeks. You heard one? No, I got it from a good source. No. Yeah, she types letters there. Yeah. Yeah, no, right, 2 weeks and a commission, yes. I saw it too. Yeah. Well, I don't think that reviewer likes her work. She always puts her in the middle of the page, and it's just a paragraph, and he just says what she does. She hopped up and down, she moves side to side, and she never gets into any discussion of the work. I don't think she really likes it, but she can't ignore her, so she's doing that. I don't know what it is.
been such an extraordinary time. I'm really glad that you cast me in this piece because there was no way I was going to be able to
see all that. You see my words?
Even my parents are in town.
No, I'm not glad I could come in.
No, but really, there's really something here. You know, I think that maybe you might be able to do something on the Tuesday project. The only problem is I was able to see Bromberg for the first time, too.
Yeah,
he's been after me longer than you have. I don't know, it's something that's a little provocative. It seems a little timely now, and the thing about... when I've seen your work, there's like a certain sense of personality that's going on. There's something moving.
Good, I do appreciate that, David.
But it's really what I would call...
The last thing is
I mean, this is a piece that's obvious created for this environment, this particular situation.
Yeah, it is.
No lights, whatever, but
you know,
I used to Black Box Theater, you know?
I know, I was very hesitant about the Black Box Theater.
Personality. How does that particularly work inside our very different
types of things?
Do you have a response to me? Do you have a response? Can you tell me? I need to know. Will you tell me tomorrow? I need to know. No, seriously. No, I mean, you've got to tell me what you think this kind of work. Look, quite frankly, I'm not interested in this work. I mean, this post-funding bullshit.
I knew something matter.
I mean, I'll tell you, the best thing you did was the whole railing. No, really. But still, in that
whole sequence,
and with Mark Russell, you know, I mean, you have this kind of naturalistic way of using people. I think that could be elaborated.
I mean, the reason I haven't approached you is because I'm fiercely independent, and I never felt like any way that you would be interested in this kind of work because you seem to like things that
I'm primarily interested in fierce independence. That's what I like. And also kind of passionate perversity.
Well, good.
No, and I think you have that. It's just that in this piece, obviously, it's still coming together, and it's something I'd really like to see. And you're not
alone.
I'm sure Sally Silvers is going through this. Robert's going through this. Nina Martin is going through this.
When life isn't really
I think that this is something that's really important to understand. I'm interested in the process of something that you're moving towards, and that's what I'd like to see if you can get at. Again, I'm not interested in this, and I'd like to see maybe coming into like our space,
to discipline it,
to be able to pull it together in ways that you haven't been able to do heretofore. What's wrong with the Tuesday project?
It's for beginners.
It's not for beginners. Get another artist on the series. That's okay. It's actually quite a good thing. You can evaluate the piece from week to week, and I think that's something you don't do enough of. You understand what I'm saying? Wait a second.
Yeah,
I have deadlines, and you're taking out. Our application is coming up for review, and I have to give them a schedule, okay? You've been asking me for months for this. I'm going to go outside and talk to Bromberg right now.
Okay.
But anyway, I'll tell you. Okay, if you can call me tomorrow, you think
really
about it, okay? I really like what you're doing, okay?
Not just
peace, but I like what you're moving towards. And I think also I look
you're
at the music.
You're a good performer, too.
Look at the music again.
I really had cold feet about doing this at all. When my proposal was accepted by Barry Rand and Perrin, I suddenly realized that I had to do it. One thing was on a page, but the idea of really doing it made me very anxious because, I mean, things really have been going well for me lately. You know, commissions and grants and all this. And here I am, I'm biting the hands that feed me. It doesn't make really sense. But I thought, well, it's a good idea, and don't think about the future, just do it. And I wasn't the only one who had cold feet. David White had cold feet, Mark Russell had cold feet. David said, I've been trying to repair my image, and now this is going to ruin it all over again. The day that I got a message on my answering machine from Barry Lane to invite me to be part of this, I had a dream that night that I had to do a performance, which was a piano performance, sitting on top of a stool, 20 feet high, on very shaky foundations, with no back. Playing piano, there was the width of this room, it was erected on high stilts, also on shaky foundations. I had no rehearsal, and if I put too much pressure on the piano, the whole construction would fall. Also, in the dream, several years before that, I had been involved in some institution where I had made a guitar. They had set up my life in such a way. amusing. One wonders if he might not be on the wrong side of the curtain at Dan's theater workshop. We are just beginning to wonder if bewilderment is intentional here when Mark emerges to toss Skura's docile body around the spacious performing area. As Skura confides her performance anxieties to Mark, we see the kind of trusting, warm, supportive relationship that can exist between women.
Listen, I went into arts administration and she went into construction, that's all. We broke up, that's it. Yeah, I know. You know, I'm getting so many complaints. I'm falling apart here. I'm just a regular guy, but I'm falling apart. And everyone's complaining to me. Everyone's laying it on me. Like, 30 people a day did this last week to tell me they didn't get cash grants, they were going to slit their throats. It was really literally a mess. It is. I don't know, everyone's complaining. And you know, it's just not like it used to be. PS-122 used to be a really alive place, and everyone was working and pitching in and out. They're all becoming stars. They're all becoming such big egos. You know, they're all doing pieces of slides about their mothers. That's really a mess. And they think they're on a new form. They're just rediscovering theater. Yeah, I mean, if you're walking, you're talking, you're doing theater, as far as I'm concerned. I know, and everyone's, it's, I don't know. Oh, hold on, I got a call, okay? Hold on. Yeah. This is like, you know, arts administration is very much like a priesthood. Yes, I mean, it's like a monastery up here. I'm just a regular guy, I'm not a bad guy, you know, I'm just a regular guy. And what can I say? There's a lot of people that want to perform here and they're flirting with me. Yeah, both sexes. Yeah, we're both flirting. And I don't know whether they want the gig or me.
Hi. Before we end the show this afternoon, just wanted to tell you that you've been absolutely fabulous audience. You know, I really get off on New York City. Whenever I pass through, I think, wow, this is the greatest city in the world. You know what I mean? I just love the energy on the streets, the throbbing pulsations of the city itself. You know what I mean? Just want you to know that you really have been a wonderful audience, and I love you all. And I want you to adore me. Because I am the hot new thing. Yes. You know, on my way over here today, I was thinking about closet space. You know how it is about closet space? How it's one of those things that you can never really get enough of. How the more you have, the more you need. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Well, that's not very funny about closet space, is it? But I am a new thing, and I did think of it today. Show this afternoon, I'd like to thank a very, very special friend of mine named Matthew. He's sitting right here. Adorable, isn't she? Yes, Beth is a very good friend of mine. She's a terrific performance artist in her own right. Lovely young lady. Beth was gracious enough to allow me to use a couple of lines from her fabulous supermarket song. Let's hear it. But I just love thanking Ben. Thanks, Ben. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, I've seen her do this hot new thing rap before. Well, I have done it before, and so what? Don't I get a chance to refine and develop my material? You know what it is to be a performer and come up with new material month after month after month? Some kind of novelty, some kind of thriller, a bunch of ingredients. let you know, to quote another very special friend of mine named Bob Tyson, to quote him, who originally borrowed this line from me, by the way, without giving me any credit for it, the bastard. You know, I'm thinking I'm not going to do anything good in public performance anymore, so when people steal my material, they don't know anything about it! Seriously, of course. To quote very magnificent Bob Telson, who's a fabulous composer and a wonderful performance artist in his own right, sex makes us enemies, but I love my enemies, you know what I mean? You're really a fabulous audience, you're just fabulous. So sophisticated, so intelligent, and so very attractive. Seriously though, folks, you know, this is a supermarket, and I am the hot new thing, and sex really does make us enemies, and I love my enemies, and I want peace in 1984, you know what I mean, you know what I mean. You know, on my way over here today, I felt like a nobody. Nowadays, when you just feel like a nobody, when you feel dispensable, when you feel like a cog in a wheel, when you want to be treated special, when you want to be really treated special, well, not wow, what a big audience, yes. Very nice, very nice. You're all wonderful. I love you so much. You know, I'm supposed to clock in at half an hour, but I just love you all so much, I just want to keep going on and on and on and on, you know what I mean? We've got any show, so I just want to tell you that I'm not here, but if you leave your name and number, I'll call you back. I'm not here, but I do love you, and I do want peace, and sex does make us enemies, and all the rest of it. And one more thing. I'm very excited about this. I want to tell you that next season in Madison Square Garden, there's going to be a new performance art series. Very excited about it. And I will be inaugurating it with the premiere of my new dynamite piece called The Planet Earth. And I know that you're all going to want to come and check it out, right? Because I really do love you, and you love me too, don't you?
For the finale, Skura imagines herself as a glamorous nightclub star, but instead, she only looks clumsy. Perhaps she's trying to demystify the performer here. Like Brett, another political artist, she shows us what goes on behind the scenes. But do we really want to know? Never mind. Artbusiness is a diverting afternoon's entertainment and a fitting start for the new band series.